This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. This is a list of characters from the Greyhawk campaign setting for the dungeons. MNOPQRSTUVWXYZA ə˸sɛrəræk ə˸sɛrəræk game information. Homeland Vast Swamp Gender Male Race Half-fiend Human Class Wizard Alignment Evil Age 800 Setting World of Greyhawk ə˸sɛrəræk 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 was a powerful wizard who became a lich, and later a demilich. Publication history: ə˸sɛrəræk first appears in the original Tomb of Horrors Adventure 1978 by Gary Gygax as the main adversary. One of the areas in the tomb is a chapel of evil, described as obviously some form of temple area. There are scenes of normal life painted on the walls, but the people have rotting flesh, skeletal hands, worms eating them, etc. 5. The adventure described him as a human magic user, cleric of surpassing evil, who took the steps necessary to preserve his life force as the lich, ə˸sɛrəræk. 10. The boxed set adventure Return to the Tomb of Horrors 1998 by Bruce Cordell included a small booklet titled The Journal of the Tomb, which notes that the character Desatiso discovered that ə˸sɛrəræk owed much of his power to Tenebris. Cordell's article Return to the Tomb of Horrors in Dragon No. 249 July 1998 mentions that, while alive, ə˸sɛrəræk built an unholy temple to a now-deceased power. When the project neared completion, he slew every worker, excavator, and consecrating priest who had assisted in the temple's construction. The article notes that the result of ə˸sɛrəræk's work was the dungeon crawl detailed in the Tomb of Horrors Module 38 in the article Open Grave by Bart Carroll and Steve Winters for the D. Orcus, using the cult's resources to construct a number of lairs and tombs, the most infamous of which would become known as the Tomb of Horrors. Some sources claim that ə˸sɛrəræk was using Orcus's worshippers to complete his own schemes, and that he felt no true loyalty to the Demon Prince. For the introduction goes on to say that, once he attained lichdom, ə˸sɛrəræk ceased paying homage to Orcus, lending credence to the notion that his worship had never been more than a means to an end. 5. ə˸sɛrəræk is mentioned in the novel Ready Player One by Ernest Cline. Relationships: ə˸sɛrəræk is the son and ally of the Balor Tarnhem, a worshipper of Orcus, and an apprentice of Vecna in life. He was the enemy of a paladin of Palor named Pentavel, and the wizard architect who designs his tomb is called Morgadam. He is revered by a group of wizards known as the Covenanticle of ə˸sɛrəræk. The necromancers of Skull City, former followers of ə˸sɛrəræk, go on to form a group known as the Votaries of Vecna, making a new home in the Black Spire on the Plain of Shadow. The Githyanki necromancer Kastya Zurith Muvya seeks to return the true ə˸sɛrəræk to existence as an ally against his people's Lich Queen. Home: the Tomb of Horrors is long ə˸sɛrəræk's home in Undeath as a demilich. He moves to the Demiplane of Moyle to complete his grand plans. There is a shrine of ə˸sɛrəræk, in the form of a 5-foot statue of a humanoid skull. On the second layer of Pandemonium history, ə˸sɛrəræk the Devourer is described as a cambion, the result of an ancient conjurer summoning a demon, a Balor named Tarnhem. Far beyond his ability to control, Tarnhem devours the conjurer and takes his human mother by force. Əsarak's mother survives her son's birth, but she is killed by a torch-wielding mob. 10 years later, the boy is rescued by none other than Vecna, the Whispered One, who kills the advisors urging him to kill the child. Instead, he takes on the half-demon as an apprentice. Even then, 10-year-old ə˸sɛrəræk loathes life, looking forward to becoming undead like his master. During Vecna's siege of Fleeth, the lich is severely wounded and rescued by ə˸sɛrəræk. Vecna subsequently promotes the cambion. It is unknown if ə˸sɛrəræk is present when Vecna is betrayed by Cas the Bloody-Handed in the 4th century before the common year, but at some point, he moves to the vast swamp where he constructs a lair for himself, colloquially known as the Tomb of Horrors and described in an adventure module of the same name. While still alive, ə˸sɛrəræk builds a subterranean temple complex in the name of Orcus, burying its architect and all of its workers within. Eventually, ə˸sɛrəræk succumbs to the lure of lichcraft, and has himself buried in a labyrinthine tomb, where he commits himself to his studies and, eventually, demilichdom, abandoning his body for the plains beyond. Many adventurers over the years attempt to raid ə˸sɛrəræk's tomb, but it is believed that none are able to destroy him. Despite some claims, the sequel module Return to the Tomb of Horrors retconned and expanded on the setting. At some point, a group of necromancers settle the area outside the tomb, creating a community of sorts known as Skull City. Acererak's tomb is revealed to be a Mir antechamber to the Demilich's true dwelling, the lost city of Moyle on the border of the negative energy plane, where he had spent thousands of years working on a process to fuse his essence with the plane and gain control over all undead throughout the multiverse according to the 3rd edition Tome of Magic. Acererak, following his destruction by adventurers completing the Tomb of Horrors, passes on to become a vestige, an ineffable, amoral entity which can be summoned and bound by characters known as binders. Acererak grants his summoner lich-like powers, including immunity to cold and the ability to speak with the dead according to the adventure. Prisoner of the Castle Perilous, Acererak created a simulacrum in the negative energy plane to torment Saint Pentavel, an old foe from his mortal life. This simulacrum eventually transforms itself into a complete being through the aid of an artifact known as the Soul Machine in 4th edition D. Members of the Circle of Eight. He is an elderly Backlinish man who walks with a limp, dresses in plain robes, and covers his shaved head with a simple turban. Al-Hamazad is a good friend of Mordenkainen, whom he has known for over 20 years. He is wary of Dromage, and holds great antipathy for Warn's Starcoat. Kerman Mind Bender of the Boneheart once served as Al-Hamazad's apprentice, but the two are now enemies. Animal Lord. Animals lords are powerful creatures of neutral good alignment that live on the outer plane of the Beastlands in the game. Each animal lord is a humanoid being, powerful like a celestial paragon or demon prince, that represents all animals of its chosen type. For example, there is a mouse lord, a lizard lord, and a hawk lord. The most well-known animal lord is Rexfellus, the cat lord. Arndarnd, also known as Arnd of T-Don, was a legendary Iridian hero who lived ages ago, before the Great Migrations, a humble priest from the south. He is famed for establishing the first paladins of Heronius among the Iridian tribes. He is also known as a possessor in more ways than one of the artifact known as the Invulnerable Code of Arnd, which he wore while leading a rebellion against the wizard Verdos. It is said that Arn's spirit still inhabits the armor that bears his name, attempting to aid the poor whenever possible. Arnd is credited with writing unknown movements of the universe, a wizardly spellbook. However, as a priest, Arnd is probably not the author of the book in question. Unless he was multi-classed, it is possible there was a wizard called Arnd separate from the legendary priest. Arnd of T-Don was named after Don Arndt, a player in the first Greyhawk campaign. Azalin main article, Azalin Rex B. Bigby main article, Bigby Greyhawk. Bucknard. Bucknard is a powerful human wizard, and former member of the Circle of Eight in Dungeons Age of Worms Adventure Path. Bucknard is referred to as Balakard. He is described as affable, esteemed, talented and powerful, yet stubborn and headstrong. He has one known sister, Mara Lee, and is also a former member of the Circle of Eight in 556 Psi. Bucknard's sister and adventuring companion, Mara Lee, was slain by Sons of Caius. Bucknard took her death and, seeing her devoured by ghoulish worms, hard depressed for years, he emerged from his depression to become one of the most potent wizards of his generation. He had dedicated himself to one overriding task, the destruction of Caius in 571, Bucknard became one of the founding members of the Circle of Eight, as Mordenkainen invited some of the most prominent mages in the Flanes to join him in a successor organization to the Citadel of Eight. At the height of his powers, Bucknard began deeply obsessing over occult manuscripts relating to the Worm God and his cult. He grew increasingly secluded and paranoid, no longer confiding even with close friends like Tensor. Abruptly resigning from the Circle of Eight in 579 Psi, he traveled to Alhaster to research his theory that the Aben Triad cult had been created there as a front for the cult of Caius. Lashona, the town's most knowledgeable expert in the occult, agreed to meet with him and directed him to the Wormcrawl Fissure, where he was captured by Dragatha the following year. After months of torture, Bucknard finally died at the hands of his own undead sister. Upon Dragatha's orders, Bucknard's soul shattered into three separate ghosts, representing his artistic, scholarly, and vengeful sides, which haunted the Fissure for decades afterwards. In 581, Bucknard's position in the circle was filled by Jalarzi Solivarian. Bucknard crafted the magic item Bucknard's Everfull Purse, which is essentially a leather pouch or small bag that refills itself each morning. Each such coin purse can replicate a different number of coins or gems, depending on which type of bag it is. Bucknard authored Inexplicable Reflections. C. Company of Seven. The Company of Seven is an adventuring group whose members later achieved great fame and power in the world of Orth while they were together. The Company of Seven explored many worlds and planes, some previous unknown. Several of the company became demigods or hero deities, and all of the company have spells and magic items named after them. In 318 Psi, the Company of Seven discovered the lost Flan citadel of Varalos and returned with a wagon load of wondrous treasures. It is not known when, how, or why the Company of Seven disbanded the members of the company were, Zagig Iragairn, a master wizard who joined some say formed this adventuring group early in his career Kiotam, a jack-of-all-trades who mastered magic, hunting, alchemy, and the old lore of the bards. Kiotam was Zagig's closest confidant and the most inventive of the group. Merlin, a paladin of Heronius and an insatiably curious artificer, his grasp of technology improved immeasurably when he traveled to Boot Hill on an unknown material plane world, and acquired his famous pair of revolvers. Nolzer, a skilled illusionist and alchemist who applied his magic to his incredible artistic ability, creating pigments and paints that allowed him to perform wonders. Qual, a ranger of Flan descent whose interest in useful spells and magic, as opposed to sheer arcane power, served the company in good stead. Heward, an accomplished bard whose mastery of both song and spell allowed him to channel powerful magic and incredible music through his instruments. Tasha, a young apprentice wizard with a morbid sense of humor, though few alive know it. Tasha was actually the legendary archmage known today as Igwilv, who went on to become the Witch Queen of Purrenland, mother of Iuz, and sometime lover of the demon prince Grazes. Cat Lord. The Cat Lord, or Master Cat, is the mysterious ruler of cats and a lord of balance, in the dungeons. Age of Worms adventure path. Dragatha was formerly a powerful red dragon, the mightiest consort of Tiamat. At some point Dragatha offended his mistress, and was forced to leave Avernus, making his way to Orth. Dragatha fell in with Caius, where he eventually became a Dracolich and Caius' greatest servant. Dragatha's lair is thought to lie in the Wormcrawl Fissure, near Rift Canyon. More historical information is given in the second edition RPGA Adventurers Guild Tournament module, Dragatha's Lair. Bruce R. Cordell, 1999, 2001. According to this history, Dragatha was forced into quiescence inactivity by Charybdis, the infamous wizard featured in the module White Plume Mountain, using a magical device called the Crown of Mortality. According to the 3rd edition White Plume Mountain web enhancement, outside the mountain is just as dangerous as inside. Robert Weiss, 2006. Dragatha was a black dragon, not a red dragon, as mentioned above, before becoming undead. An expedition to Dragatha's lair is told in the song The Claws of Dragatha, which is believed to have been penned sometime in the 5th century. Psi Dragatha is mentioned in a pictorial map featured in the White Plume Mountain module, beyond to the lair of Dragatha, the undead dragon where fabulous riches and hideous death await. Dromage main article, Dromage. Eclavdra. Eclavdra is a powerful, ravishing drow priestess of Lolth. Eclavdra is known for her cruelty and complex scheming, and her total lack of compassion. She eliminates rivals before they can become threats. In Gary Gygax's Gord the Rogue novels, Eclavdra is depicted as incredibly beautiful, with jet black skin, violet eyes, perfect breasts, and silvery or snow white hair. However, she is as evil as she is beautiful. Eclavdra is the leader of House Isleserves and the most powerful priestess of Lolth. Her former consorts include Dirash and the demon lord Grazes. She also has a son, Athix, with Stallman Klim. She helped create the slave lords. The slave lord Edrav is her former protege, a native of the city of Erelhai Sinlu and member of House Isleserves. Eclavdra has served other powerful entities in the past, notably the elder elemental Eye and Grazes. For a time, she could be found at Yuz's court, acting as an ambassador after Eclavdra's alliance with the elder elemental Eye jeopardized Lolth's attempt to bring the world of Orth into the Demonweb pits. She fell out of favor with her goddess. Her consort Dirashan, seeing which way the wind was blowing, gave away details on her stronghold's defenses to her enemies among the other drow houses. Though Eclavdra escaped, she regained Lolth's favor by seducing and eventually betraying Grazes. Athix, a powerful half-demon drow, was the child born of that union. Eclavdra now serves as Lolth's chief diplomat, as well as the supreme mortal ruler of her organization and religion. Lolth admires ambition above loyalty, and thus Eclavdra is one of the most favored denizens of the Abyss. Eclavdra is a major villain in Gygax's Gord the Rogue novels. She also has a clone in the series, Leda, who becomes Gord's lover in the novel Against the Giants. Eclavdra was killed in the novels. It is revealed that Nemus the Mage was once her servant, but is no longer created by Gary Gygax. Eclavdra first appeared in Hall of the Fire Giant King 1978. Eclavdra was initially depicted as the High Priestess of the Elder Elemental God in Gygax's Gord the Rogue novels. She is shown to be in the service of the Demon Lord Grazes in later dungeons. Malicious intent to form the Slave Lords, settling in the hidden city of Suderim in the Pamarj after the Slave Lords lost power in 580 Psi. Edrav left the organization and returned to Erelhai Sinlu. Eli Tamorist. Eli Tamorist is a wizard and the primary antagonist in the Mordenkainen's Fantastic Adventure module, described as a gaunt human with black hair and facial hair. His forearms and hands have been replaced by those of an unknown demon, giving him additional powers which make him a more powerful adversary in the module. In the original adventure, published in 1984, Timorist had little background, and served only as the owner of the Tome of the Black Heart, an artifact which Eli discovered in the Lost City of Elders somewhere to the east in the original module's timeline. Eli is slain by Mordenkainen, who is the character run by Gary Gygax. Mordenkainen was also printed in the module as a pre-generated character for players to use if they wished in 2004. Dungeon Magazine published More Castle in issue number 112. This was an update to the original module, and presented a continuation of Eli's story in the update. Eli was resurrected by a Null cleric of Yinahu who sought the power of the Tome of the Black Heart and its guardian, Kurzid. In this update, Eli is bent on revenge against Mordenkainen and his associates. Little is known of Eli Timorist's early years. What is known is that at some point, he visited the Lost City of the Elders, possibly as a member of a seeker expedition, where he discovered the Tome of the Black Heart, a powerful artifact which gave Timorist the ability to summon and control a powerful demon named Kurzid. Timorist set up Kurzid as a false god in order to expand his power, and provided sacrifices to the demon in the 550 SI. Timorist led a band of renegade seekers to the ruins of Moor Castle, which he successfully entered and began looting. However, Timorist had an ulterior agenda as well, for he wished to establish a concealed place to summon Kurzid in the 560 SI. Mordenkainen and his companions Bigby, Rigby, and Irag delved into the dungeons to face off against Timorist and his seekers, seemingly killing Timorist and several of his men and making off with many of the choicest treasures of the subcomplex. However, Timorist was not dead for long. He was raised by a cleric of the Null demon lord Yinahu soon, with a revamped seeker organization. Timorist began delving deeper into the secrets of the castle, recently even finding some communication between the outlying complex he has occupied and the main dungeon complex under the castle proper. Timorist eventually discovered a way into the true dungeons of Moor Castle, and set about gathering the power required to take his revenge. Irak's cousin. Main article, Irak's cousin Everd. Everd, also known as Everd the Black, is a neutral evil archmage responsible for developing such spells as Everd's Black Tentacles. Everd is known to operate from the Sheldamar Valley, where he deals as an information broker. He is an enemy of Mordenkainen. Everd is a man of sturdy build and average musculature, with pale skin and long dark hair. He wears rich clothing, often belted with a white sash, and a large purple gemstone hangs from his throat. He is a charming man with a ready grin. Everd was originally a minor noble in the March of Bissell. He came to be a very successful broker of information, and many sages and loremasters send him knowledge in return for solving vexing questions of their own. If he doesn't know something, someone in his network does. He is ambitious and cunning, and will readily betray his allies if it suits him. He can be found in any of the major cities of the Sheldamar in addition to the commonly known spell, Everd's Black Tentacles. Everd has also developed the following spells, Everd's All-Seeing Worm and Everd's Menacing Tentacles. Everd is known to have authored the following works, Legendary of Phantoms and Ghosts. G. Gord the Rogue. Main article, Gord the Rogue I Igwilv. Main article, Igwilv Iuz. Main article, Iuz J. Jalarzi Solivarian. Main article, Jalarzi Solivarian K. Kargoth. Kargoth, more commonly known as Saint Kargoth, is a Death Knight of great power. He is also known as the Betrayer, and King of the Death Knights. His symbol is a glowing green skull. Saint Kargoth is of massive size and build, standing 7 feet tall. His skeletal features are a baleful, glowing green color thanks to the fiendish surgeries and grafts his patron Demogorgon has subjected him to. He rides a glowing green chariot drawn by 6 nightmares. Saint Kargoth possesses the bilious sphere, a corrupt parody of the orb of Sol. Saint Kargoth is a powerful servant of Demogorgon steeped in the politics of the abyss. He is the mortal foe of Saint Benador of the Ashen Hand, who was chosen over Kargoth to lead the knight protectors of the great kingdom. Kargoth is worshipped along with the other original death knights by the Sunseb Sodality and regarded as a saint by renegade elements in the Church of Hexter Saint. Kargoth is currently contending with Merland over an artifact known as the Quenon. Saint Kargoth dwells in Kolorinth, a stone fortress atop a rocky pinnacle protruding from the sea in the Demogorgon's realm of Gaping Maw. While the Death Knight is often away on business involving the Prime Material Plane, his fortress always hosts important human visitors. A sickly brown pool in Kargoth's private quarters is a two-way portal to Demogorgon's Palace of Abysm, formerly a 2nd to 3rd century Psy Torquin nobleman and paladin of Heronius known as Lord Kargoth of Mansbridge. Kargoth was born 141 Psi in the Great Kingdom of Erdi after Benador was chosen over Kargoth to lead the Night Protectors. Kargoth's jealousy and bitterness allowed him to be seduced by the demon prince Demogorgon, who granted him the power he craved by transforming him into the first Death Knight in 203 Psi. Kargoth, in turn, gathered 13 fellow Night Protectors to his cause, who were also transformed into Death Knights by Demogorgon. Kargoth formerly lived at Castle Farlanst, located on the Erdi coast between Wyntha and Roland, until it was destroyed by the Night Protectors of the Great Kingdom in 247 Psi. Kargoth's betrayal is regarded by many as the beginning of the end of the Night Protectors. Kargoth's famous sword, Gorgorine the Shatterer, was lost when he battled the legendary Haynard of the Whiteguard, Cass the Bloody-Handed. Cass the Bloody-Handed was the most trusted lieutenant of the despotic lich Vecna, and wielder of the Sword of Cass after many years of loyal service to Vecna. Cass eventually betrayed his master. It is said that the sword itself whispered to Cass, convincing him to slay his master and usurp his power. The battle destroyed Vecna's rotting tower, and cost the lich his left hand and eye. Cass himself was flung across the multiverse to Vecna's citadel Cavitius on the quasi-elemental plane of Ash. The time he spent so close to the negative energy plane changed him into a vampire, and he decided he would be called Cass the Destroyer. The first edition of Dungeon Master's Guide does not specifically state that Cass severed Vecna's hand and eye, only that they, and the Sword of Cass, were the only objects that survived the battle. Vecna, Hand of the Revenant depicts the lich losing his left hand and eye to destructive magic casts by priests of Foltis, presumably to be restored at a future point in the story. Numerous third edition sources state with certainty that Vecna's hand and eye were severed by Cass's blade. Sources are also not in complete agreement as to when or how Cass became a vampire, as some state he gained his dark gift before his betrayal, while others state that he gained it after when Vecna was defeated during his bid for control of Orth. Cass was freed from his centuries of imprisonment, only to find himself facing a shapeless wall of mist when it cleared. He was master of the domain of Tovig. Across the burning peaks from Vecna's domain of Cavitius, Cass waged an endless war of attrition with Vecna's forces in the hopes of retrieving the Sword of Cass from Vecna's citadel, where he erroneously believed Vecna held it. The Burning Peaks cluster did not appear in the third edition Ravenloft campaign setting, because White Wolf Game Studio did not license characters that are explicitly tied to other D. Himself as protector of the Flan enclave of Tostenka in the Griff Mountains by c-1100 Psi. The wizard was driven out of the settlement circa -800 Psi. Charybdis took over White Plume Mountain, near Rift Canyon, with an army of gnomish warriors, personally slaying the previous guardian of the mountain. The druid Aguereth Charybdis dwelt in White Plume Mountain for 9 centuries afterward, finally abandoning his lair sometime in the 1990s Psi to further his research. By the late 5th century Psi, a band of adventurers known as the Brotherhood of the Tome stole the magical weapons Blackrazor, Frostrazor, Wave, and Whelm from White Plume Mountain. Realizing they needed protection from further such raids, the Gnomes of the Mountain opened up Charybdis' old laboratory, deploying magic that rewrote the personalities of those who read it with partial copies of Charybdis' own. The result was the first false Charybdis, a gnome who truly believed itself to be the original, though this false Charybdis eventually died. Further ones came into being: Nightfare, Spatterdock, Killjoy, Moss Mutter, and Zawar Orlaisi all believe themselves to be the one true Charybdis. Charybdis authored Pyranomicon El Lashona. Lashona is a silver dragon vampire and the highest ranking cleric to the god Caius. Centuries ago, she was slain by Dragatha, the Dracolich and most powerful servant of Caius. However, upon her death, the dark god resurrected her as a vampire. Over the centuries, Lashona became the most devoted servant to Caius, to the point of declaring herself his wife. When the Age of Worms arrives, she is jealous of her god's favoritism of Dragatha, yet too weak to act against the Dacolich. Along with an Avalakia Mahudral, she founded the Aben Triad, a cult that believes Arithnal, god of slaughter, Hexter, god of tyranny, and Vecna, god of secrets, are three parts of the one evil god in reality. However, known only to herself and Mahudral, the cult's activities empower Caius and help usher his prophesied Age of Worms. She holds great influence over the kingdom Redhand in the Bandit Kingdom and its ruler Prince Zeech, where she makes her home, appearing as a beautiful elven woman. Lashona is a major antagonist in the Age of Worms campaign. Liamond. Liamond, also known as Liamond the Red, is a clever and practical archmage and former member of the Circle of Eight. Greyhawk Ruins names him as a rumored member of the Ring of Five. He always kept his whereabouts circumspect, but it is thought he once lived in Metahia Liamond, an immigrant from the East, was already ancient when he joined the Circle of Eight in approximately 571 Psi. He retired from the Circle in 576 Psi. Citing other compelling uses of his time, he was replaced by Odaluke later that year and has been seldom heard from since, and not at all in recent years. Liamond developed the spells Liamond's Hidden Lodge, Liamond's Lamentable Belaborment, Liamond's Secret Chest, Liamond's Secure Shelter, Liamond's Tiny Hut, and Liamond's Trap. He authored or co-authored Architecture with Mordenkainen, Forgotten Arts of Oratory Magnetism, Thesis on the Planes of Antimatter, and Transcendental Impenetrabilities. Liamond is the creator of Liamond's Plate and Cup, made of engraved silver, gold, or platinum. These finely crafted dishes produce delicious meals and alcoholic drinks on command, at variable frequencies per day depending on the nature of the item after use. They must be cleaned with sweet or holy water once a week or permanently stop functioning. Liamond was the player character of Len Lakofka, who has stated vehemently that his character was never a member of the Circle of Eight. Instead, in the Orth Journal No. 10, he suggested that the Circle member was an imposter whose true name was Gygax. The class levels, birth date, and alignment attributed to him above come from Lakofka's Orth Journal article, and must be considered apocryphal. Loran. Sir Loran is a former human knight of Sundi who became a death knight. Loran is eternally haunted by the spirit of his murdered wife before his death. Loran was the final lord of Trollpyre Keep, a minor estate located in southern Sundi, near the vast swamp. An evil, twisted man who hid his true nature behind a mask of honor and stoicism, Loran sought to be known for founding a great warrior household. To this end, Loran took Lyra, a beautiful dancer, as his wife, but she bore him a daughter instead of a son. Enraged, Loran slew his wife, daughter, and the midwife, using his magic blade. Trollpyre's defender, Loran's mother-in-law, a priestess, put a curse upon Loran. He was to die painfully in battle, then rise as one of the undead, and be haunted by the spirits of his wife and daughter for all eternity. Upon rising as a death knight, Loran was unable to sire children, and thus his line died with him some time after his transformation. Loran lured a troop of wandering performers to his keep and tortured them to death. This act succeeded in drawing him into the mists of Ravenloft, eventually making his way to Cavitius. Sir Loran entered Vecna's service. However, Lyra and her child were also there, and continued to haunt him. Lorana Cath. Lady Lorana Cath is a death knight, one of the 13 who betrayed the knight protectors of the Great Kingdom in the game. Cath was once a cleric of Hexter of great power, and she is considered the catalyst for the betrayal of the Death Knights through her seduction of Lord Kargoth. Lady Lorana Cath augments her skeletal visage with gruesome masks made from the severed faces of young maidens. She often accessorizes her plate armor with a bloody apron and bridle veil. Within the Greyhawk world, Cath was known as a powerful priestess of Hexter in life and was admitted into the Knight Protectors in an unorthodox manner, as a recognition for her medical skills on the battlefield. However, Cath was possessed of a scheming and ambitious mind, and desired to marry herself to a leading Erdi noble to aid in her pursuit of power in the Great Kingdom. She was betrothed to Prince Maranvich in 196, but the engagement soon fell apart after the death of Knight Commander Lord Nidramon the Hextorian in 202 Psi. Cath began to court the favor of Lord Kargoth, a powerful Erwanan who most felt would be chosen as Nidramon's replacement. However, when the Council Gallant instead chose Sir Benador Monlith of Chathold, Cath was there to fan the fires of Kargoth's rage after Kargoth failed to overcome Benador in a duel at the Later's investiture in 203 Psi. He was seduced by the demon Lord Demogorgon, who transformed the mighty paladin into Orth's first Death Knight. Kargoth soon assembled 13 of his fellow Knight Protectors, including Cath, to plot revenge. Kargoth led his allies on a raid of the Temple of Lothan near Rel Devon, in order to seize an ancient Iridian artifact known as the Orb of Sol using foul magic granted to him by Demogorgon. Kargoth used the orb to deliver his allies to his master, transforming them into Death Knights as well, and also to unleash a great demonic horror known as Arendegrost, Maw of the Abyss, upon the land. Cath, unlike Kargoth, has no interest in advancing the plans of Demogorgon, and still considers herself a priestess of Hexter. She maintains an estate to the northwest of the Stringan region of the North Kingdom, where she amuses herself with research into the Ur-Flan and their necromantic practices. It is said that Cath's research into these ancient sorcerers led her to develop the means to create Animi, the unique undead servitors of Ivid V. In the last years of his reign, Cath supposedly created the process as a means of reversing the transformation invoked upon herself. Lum the Mad. Baron Lum the Mad is a mighty Iridian warlord whose power was at least partially due to his possession of the artifact known as the Infernal Machine Lum was betrayed by his former general, Luke O. When the latter came to possess the artifact later known as the Mighty Servant of Luke O, their final conflict left a large area wasted. A mysterious mist appeared, and Lum plunged through a dimensional rift to the plane of Limbo, where Lum waited for centuries, his connection to the machine leaving him unable to die. The machine was housed in the fortress Rifter, near Roxas, until the city was destroyed in 586 Psi. Quite likely due to the machine's wild influence, Baron Lum lived a life obsessed with war and conquest, trained for it from boyhood. When he was rewarded for thinking and planning but punished for frivolous behavior, his first experience with the love of the opposite sex was twisted, painful, and empty. He grew to be a handsome man. With rugged features marred with only a few scars, more than 8 centuries ago he discovered the sword Drunioth, an artifact sacred to Tharizdun. He wielded it against Ur-Flanae sorcerers of the Thelwood, but lost it during the fray. He spent the rest of his time on Orth searching for it, the effort slowly driving him insane. Years later, while exploring a castle his armies had conquered, he came across the machine that would bear his name, a horseshoe-shaped nightmare of black metal, festooned with levers, dials, sockets, wires, and plugs. Through trial and error, he learned to manipulate it, learning more about its functioning than even the wisest sages have since then. If he was mad before, the blasphemous technology of the device drove him over the edge, but it also brought him great power. With his disciplined troops and his new powers, he carved out a mighty fiefdom. It is said that, with the machine, he brought no fewer than 50 new species of monsters into the world. He thought nothing of barrages of fire that annihilated large numbers of his own troops, so long as he carried the day. His reign was one of cruelty and horror, but it is credited in part for the impressive of Iridian successes in the days before. Their victories over the rival Sul and Flan were assured. Lum's reign approached its twilight when his formerly loyal subordinate, General Luke O, discovered the Mighty Servant artifact in the Belching Vortex that would become known by his name. Some believe the Mighty Servant and the Infernal Machine were created by the same otherworldly artificer, and the appearance of them both so close together was no coincidence. It is said the quasi-deity Crovis awoke from his sleep during this period to help bring Lum's tyranny to an end with the power of the Mighty Servant. Luke O gathered a host that matched Lum's own. The two armies clashed many times before their final battle. When Lum disappeared, the fate of Luke O is unknown. Lum and his infernal machine have been featured in the computer games Baldur's Gate 2, Throne of Baal, as being imprisoned in Watcher's Keep, and briefly at the end of Planescape, Torment, when the final boss refers to a time when the Nameless One danced sorceries with Lum the Mad. M. Melf main article, Melf Mordenkainen main article, Mordenkainen Merland main article, Merland N. Nerev Gaskal. Nerev Gaskal is the Lord Mayor of the Free City of Greyhawk, also known as Greyhawk City. He has held this position since 570 Psi. He is also the Assistant Guildmaster of Greyhawk's Guild of Thieves. Nerev Gaskal was born 540 Psi in Greyhawk at some point. He joined the Guild of Thieves, which was then under the leadership of Guildmaster Arental, in 570 Psi. Gaskal became Lord Mayor of Greyhawk. It is assumed that he was a member of the Directing Oligarchy prior to that, one of the youngest mayors in Greyhawk's history. Gaskal and his allies on the Directing Oligarchy, who include Org Nenshin, his best friend, former partner, and guildmaster of the Thieves Guild, brought great changes and dynamism to the city government, including reforming the city's currency. Gaskal has led Greyhawk for almost 3 decades, bringing the city to victory over its enemies, expanding its territory, and increasing its wealth. In fact, Gaskal is regarded as one of Greyhawk's greatest mayors, second only to Zagig Iragairn. Nolzer Nolzer is an illusionist and alchemist and former thief, once part of the famed Company of Seven. After many adventures, he rose to the status of quasi-deity as a member of the Company of Seven. He adventured with Zagig Iragairn, Heward, Kiotom, Merland, Qual, and Tasha. He still has not forgiven Kiotom. Nolzer began his career in Radagast City in the County of Ernst as a thief. His early travels took him to many places, including Blackmoor and the Pirate Isles. He joined Zagig Iragurn's Company of Seven, accompanying them on wild adventures in the early 300 Psi. He journeyed with Merland and Kiotom to the Cold Marshes in search of ruins of a civilization of sorcerous amphibians. There the three adventurers battled a lich queen known as the Weird of the Cold Heath. Nolzer argued that they should keep her disease-causing staff for use as a weapon against IUZ, but Kiyotam decided to reverse its effects instead, creating an item known as Kiyotam's Staff of Purification. Nolzer and Kiyotam's differences became irreconcilable more than a century ago when, according to repute, Kiyotam borrowed one of Nolzer's formulas in order to aid the creation of his famed Kiyotam's ointment. This caused a permanent wedge in the Company of Seven, and the group went their separate ways. Nolzer went into seclusion, Zagig retired to his castle, and Merland and Kiyotam left the Orth behind to explore other planes of existence. Nolzer's reclusiveness has caused his fame to fade in recent decades. Nolzer created Nolzer's Marvelous Pigments and Nolzer's Orb Nystuhl. Nystuhl is an archmage and member of the Circle of Eight. He is also the most famous native of the Duchy of Ten at one time. Nystuhl had an apprentice named Yanina. Nystuhl developed the spells Nystuhl's Magic Aura, Nystuhl's Undetectable Aura, Nystuhl's Blacklight Burst, Nystuhl's Blackmote, Nystuhl's Blazing Beam, Nystuhl's Crystal Dagger, Nystuhl's Crystal Dirk, Nystuhl's Dancing Dwayomer, Nystuhl's Dancing Werelight, Nystuhl's Enveloping Darkness, Nystuhl's Expeditious Fire Extinguisher, Nystuhl's Flash, Nystuhl's Golden Revelation, Nystuhl's Gru Conjuration, Nystuhl's Lightburst, Nystuhl's Radiant Arch, and Nystuhl's Radiant Baton. He authored Librum of the Great Paravisual Emanation and Metaphysics of Mathematics. Nystuhl is one of the famous mages whose spells were included in the 1988 Greyhawk Adventures Hardbound. OOBMI, sometimes called Lord OBMI, is a murderous mountain dwarven fighter and member of Yuz's Boneshadow. He has iron gray hair, has a taciturn personality, and delights in playing power games. Originally from the Crystal Mists, he is known as the Hammer of Iuz due to his use of the dwarven throwing hammer, and OBMI the Wily for his cunning. He appears in the Gord the Rogue novels as an enemy of Gord, Leda, and Eklavdra. OBMI is sometimes accompanied by a deranged grey elf fighter, mage named Keek, and a gnomish illusionist, rogue named Gleed. In the past, OBMI was a slave of, then advisor to, the fire giant King Snur Ironbelly. Obmi's early history is unknown. He is known to have been a slave of the Fire Giant King, Snur Ironbelly of the Helfernesses, from 546 to 551 Psi by 551 Psi. OBMI had proven his worth as an advisor, and served King Snur for the next 25 years in that role. In 576 Psi, Snur's hall was raided by adventurers. OBMI escaped by masquerading as a dwarven prince. Shortly after his escape, OBMI joined the service of Iuz. Creative origins. OBMI first appeared in Gary Gygax's original Castle Greyhawk campaign between 1972 and 1973, where he was placed in an old magical laboratory in the center of the third level of the dungeon. Gygax gave him boots of speed, a dwarven thrower, and several Gnoll henchmen. He also had a magical device that shot a ray that teleported the PCs to another part of the dungeon if they failed their saves. After many unsuccessful attempts, the PCs the Citadel of Eight finally destroyed the device, but OBMI escaped. Their hatred of OBMI did not diminish. Odaluk main article. Odaluk Otto. Otto is a powerful human wizard, and member of the Circle of Eight. Otto is short and rotund, with shoulder-length curly hair, and a well-groomed mustache. He tends to dress in fine, expensive garb. Originally a priest of Bakab in Almor, Otto soon found he had an uncanny knack for wizardry, and became quite skilled in the arcane arts at the secret prompting of Mordenkainen. He became a henchman of Robler for a time. Otto is a lover of fine food and music. He owns a manor in Greyhawk City's Garden Quarter, where he is a generous patron of the arts. In Gary Gygax's original Greyhawk home game, Otto was a denizen of the second level beneath Castle Greyhawk. Robler, Tenser, and Tarek encountered him while adventuring there. Otto was subdued by Tenser, but decided to work for Robler. He subsequently gained levels rapidly, rarely straying from Robler's side. In the original campaign, Otto was chaotic neutral and reached 18th level as a single-class magic user of chaotic neutral alignment. Otto is known to have authored or co-authored the following works: Aestrella, a magical aria of his composition and arcane manipulations of the entourage. Otto is responsible for developing the commonly known spell Otto's Irresistible Dance. Many of the spells he has created are specialized by sound, sonic, or musical motifs. Otto has also developed the following additional spells: Otto's Chime of Release, Otto's Crystal Rhythms, Otto's Drums of Despair, Otto's Gong of Isolation, Otto's Imperative Ambulation, Otto's Silver Tongue, Otto's Soothing Vibrations, Otto's Sure-Footed Shuffle, Otto's Tin Soldiers, Otto's Tonal Attack, Otto's Tones of Forgetfulness, and Otto's Warding Tones are Araray main article, Araray Rigby. Rigby, also known as Rigby the Patriarch, was a major cleric of Bakab and a companion of the Archmage Mordenkainen in his prime. Rigby had black hair and chestnut-colored eyes. He customarily wore robes of light gray and off-white. He was a fiery evangelist for his uncaring deity, often demanding that unbelievers convert or die. He pursued temporal power in order to better maintain the spirituality of those among him besides Bakab. He also revered Zagaj. Rigby began his career as a priest at a small chapel at some point. He met with Mordenkainen and other members of an adventuring band the wizard was forming, and soon became a founding member of the Citadel of Eight. Rigby was one of the adventurers, along with Mordenkainen, Bigby and Irag, who delved into Moor Castle to face off against Eli Tamorist and the demon Kurzit. Rigby, along with Mordenkainen's Citadel of Eight, also delved into the dungeons underneath the Temple of Elemental Evil in 570 Psi. Rigby accompanied Lord Robler into the dungeons underneath Castle Greyhawk in an ill-fated attempt to free, and then permanently kill, the demigod Iuz, who had been imprisoned there since 505 Psi by Zagig Iragarn. Sometime after the failure and release of the demigod, he settled down in Greyhawk City as the head of city's great temple of Bakab, and spent much of the balance of his life in retirement in 597 Psi. Rigby died of natural causes in Verbobank, as depicted in the module Expedition to the Ruins of Greyhawk. His body was taken to Greyhawk for burial. It would be Rigby's death that set in motion the latest of Yuz's gambits to destroy the city, revenge himself on Mordenkainen and Robler, and strike out for domination of the Flanes. As with many of the original Greyhawk characters, Rigby grew out of a character played by Gary Gygax during the first campaigns run by him and Robert J. Kuntz. Rigby originated as one of a series of henchmen characters who followed Mordenkainen, and was named by Kuntz employing a serial naming convention. All the names ended in Igby that also yielded the name Bigby. He first appeared in print in the 1980 supplement The Rogues Gallery, and was revised 4 years later by Kuntz for use as a player character for Mordenkainen's Fantastic Adventure Robler. Main article, Robler S. Certain is a powerful priest of St. Cuthbert and member of the Citadel of Eight. He is rumored to be a member of the Ring of Five, though he had low intelligence and was never truly respected by the rest of the Citadel of Eight. Certain was well-meaning, kindly, and likable, and seen as useful. He liked to adventure, but wasn't seen as competent enough to go on his own, as he was often too dumb to run away when in danger, and he seldom planned ahead. Certain was slain 569 Psi at the Battle of Emrydi Meadows, having finally been permitted to adventure without the rest of his party. Tenser blamed Mordenkainen for his death and left the Citadel of Eight over the issue. Certain is associated with certain spell immunity, though as a 10th level cleric he is unlikely to have developed what was an 8th level magic user spell himself. Certain's ring grants a continuous certain spell immunity effect while worn. It is currently in the possession of Lacaster of Wine. The certain is said in Dragon No. 82 to have authored Arcane Resistance of Dwarves and Halflings, an arcane spellbook. Certain was originally a cleric played by Ernie Gygax, one of Gary Gygax's sons, like Tenser, another of Ernie's characters. Certain is an anagram of his name. Ernest Ernie also played Irak's cousin and Irak, although Certain was clearly labeled a cleric in the Rogues Gallery and the Living Greyhawk Journal No. 0, the existence of the spell immunity spell, his purported authorship of a wizardly spellbook, and a rumor in Greyhawk Ruins all point to the existence of a wizard called Certain.